When I was 5 years old, everyone said I was such a lovely child. As if that was all they could remember about me. At 25, I understood why they needed to say this. As if children could escape the rituals of protest. As if children never had to compromise. This I know because of Alexandra and Jess, two young sisters whose lives were changed at the strike of a match.
Jess, my sister, we're stuck together, so I'm sticking thin.
Morning. I'm a
Let's go to Rapunzel's castle.
Oh, I don't know.
It's Rapunzel. Hey, wait. It's Rapunzel.
Move away from the fence. You with the blanket. Move away from the fence. I repeat, move away from the fence. I'm warning you. Westgate B Tower to Key Control.
Key Control.
We have a bit of a problem here. There's one of those Doukhobors up against the north fence, and I think I see smoke. What are my orders, sir?
Doukhobor, for Christ's sake. If she sets fire to the dry grass, we're all in trouble.
Okay, I'll fire a warning shot.
Never forget the sounds that morning. First the singing, then the shot, and then the sirens. A little girl had been shot. Her name was Alexandra Braun. This I know because I often swap knitting patterns with her mom. And written in the margins and between the lines, she told me about her life. She was a Doukhobor and was kept isolated from us in general population. And it finally dawned on me that children and prisoners have something in common. You're neither seen nor heard. And for both, time passes by too slow.